municipality to Supreme Court, it's a taking, be it if it's a legislative, executive, judicial restriction of property use. The state actor is irrelevant. If what was once a right of the private property no longer exists, it has been taken, no less than if the state is physically appropriated or destroyed. You must pay for all these trees you said can't come down. Like Kenny King said, you want the tree, go get it. I've written to everyone all over the country. I've got a lot of people interested in what you all are doing. It started with me being blackballed when I made the complaint years ago about I wanted to bid on the cemetery trees, and that was Dan's tropical little nest egg. How dare I try to bid against him for the cemetery trees. I was blackballed, got caught. There was a reprimand from Sean Smith to Cynthia Snell, Cynthia Dominic Google. They caught her, red-handed. That followed up with me starting getting tree violations, God could not want. For ficus trees that were less caliber inches than even little 3-inch ficus, got hauled up for violations of that. Then when I started seeing that what you all are doing, you might want to put a cap on when you're charging people for tree removals, maybe a couple hundred dollars, and some of you said, what a good idea, I don't see that person here. He resigned? You make him resign? As soon as I said that, I did a lawsuit against me with, oh my God, who could imagine, Ron Ramsingh, swearing as a private citizen that my crew threw large limbs and trucks and damaged and destroyed trucks and just threw just large limbs and the trucks were shaking and shaking and I was destroying this truck and my crews were destroying this truck and there's no damage to the truck and it was settled by me washing the guy's truck. And he told me he was coerced into filing this. Was it by you two? Because right after I approached Ron Ramsingh about this, that's when I get my violation. That's when he refused to sign my emergency tree removal permit where a tree had caused 251,000 gallons of loss of water. Are you insane? That's a question. There is nothing I can find except, when I went to Dennis Ward, state attorney, asked if he would hold you all for extortion and racketeering. $5 million sits there. We already got the figures. We know the players. We know who's been violated. All I gotta do, get those people and they can demand their money back and have a big, nice class action lawsuit. Mayor King said, sue us. We've got a lot of money. Why? Because the citizens of Key West pay the lawsuits. Yay, you all get to do whatever you want. Just railroad through all private citizens, all you want, because you depend on Sean Smith and the Miami attorneys and whoever you get to just roll people until they got no money left. That's what you do. That's what you do. That's what the city of Key West does. They make you endure such a long lawsuit that you are either dead or broke or homeless. But some people don't give up, and I'm one of them. What you're doing is not right. I didn't like it that my son died when his palm tree, he was 6 feet up on a ladder on, was touching the frond of another palm tree that the city had planted directly under the power lines. And the tree he was on touched the frond of that tree, and he got electrocuted. I thought about bringing his shoe with a little tiny pinhole in it, where he got electrocuted, and a photo of his hand fused together. Maybe so you get it, and you wipe that grin off your face. I don't take it lightly that 5 years later, you're still planting these trees under the power lines and allowing them to stay there. I don't laugh about that. I don't laugh about the pictures that I took of the tree that was on fire from your light, because the city hadn't trimmed the ficus tree and it was bearing on the light and it caught the ficus on fire and the ficus tree ran right by my customer's pool. I don't think that's
funny. At some point, you're going to have to get back on track here. I haven't said anything for quite a long time. I told you to have a rant at the proposal and I've stood out of the line.
That's fine.
Point,
I
at
think
some point
I
need to bring it back and sum it up so the city can sum up theirs and come to some sort of decision.
Yes, I do. I applied for a permit as required for emergency removal. pursuant to section 110.27, except for trees meeting the criteria of 110.327.1. Meaning you don't have to decide those. 110.327.1 is hazard to public utilities. See, you don't get to decide this. I apply for an emergency permit as soon as I know that I'm going to take a tree down. If the tree fell on somebody, I'm taking it down now. Sorry, you're not available. Because you all are never available. So this emergency thing is ridiculous anyway, because there's nobody you can call on the weekend. If I have an emergency and I tell landscape coordinator that I have an emergency and 251,000 gallons of water have been lost and confirmed by FAA and confirmed that it was from that tree root. If I have an emergency, see, I don't need your approval. I can use my, see, I'm as smart as you are. And so is my homeowner. And we can decide if we need to take that tree down. Because it might cost him $3,000 in lost water, and I don't know who else knows what it might let germs and contamination. I mean, God knows what got into the public water supply. When a pipe breaks, all kinds of contaminants get in. We use our best judgment. We apply for an emergency removal permit. It met the criteria. Number one, hazard to public utilities. We were told by the urban landscape coordinator Lindsay and the secretary across the aisle from her that they were horrified that this could happen. We were told that there would be a permit on the desk on Monday morning and we could take the tree down. See, I met my legal obligation because I only had to tell you there was an emergency, take a picture of the tree, and get my application in within 2 days after I took it down. Then I met all my legal requirements in your own ordinances. You can then either deny it or approve it, and then if you deny it, section 110.337, appeals of the tree commission's permit decisions may be taken to the city commission. Appeals of permit decisions. Appeals of permit decision. See, you can't haul me in on a violation. You don't have any ordinance or authority to do it. Disapproval 110.332. If the application for a tree removal permit is disapproved, the applicant may modify or resubmit the application or 110.337. They can appeal it. That's why you wouldn't deny it, isn't it, Mr. White? You didn't want all this other stuff to come up. You didn't want to have to give a reason you were denied because you didn't want to put your name on the line that 251,000 gallons of water lost and broken pipes and contaminated the water supply of Key West wasn't an emergency because you look rather foolish for me. You and Ron Ramsingh went on a campaign against me because I tried to rein in your supply of money. You can do what you want. I'm not going to agree to any settlement ever in this unconstitutional court where you have no legal authority over private homeowners and emergencies like this. And you refuse to put your name on anything. You refuse to take care of the city-owned trees and do your job. You refuse to violate commercial properties that don't meet standards. Of course, you know there's never going to be a settlement agreement with me when you violate me unlawfully after things that there are no violations. You can conjure up anything.